Good afternoon, students. In the last video, I have discussed about the symptoms of gastric ulceration. One of the causes of gastric ulceration is Ulcer-Elution syndrome. Risk factor for gastric ulceration is Ulcer-Elution syndrome, which is caused by gastrin secreting tumor. Here, I can explain why gastrin is the important factor for peptic ulceration. The main secretory process of acyl secretion is controlled by parietal cells. In the parietal cells, H2O and CO2 react with each other in presence of carbonic anhydrase enzyme. The production of H+ ion is maintained by H+K+ATPase pump, which is present at the mucosal cell surface. This H+K+ATPase channel is controlled by several factors, and one of the factors which is contributing for the acyl secretion is gastrin. This is the main factor which stimulates H+ ion synthesis. If anyhow gastrin secretion is increased, which is secreted from gastric G cells, the overall stimulation of acyl secretion is automatically increased. And you know that acyl is the main factor responsible for peptic ulceration. In peptic ulceration, acyl secretion is tremendously increased. Because of this reason, necrosis, degeneration, and perforation are performed at the gastric mucosal layer. In your physiology class, I have mentioned the mechanism of acyl secretion. In this semester, in pharmacology, you will also read about these substances. Several factors which can control limitation of acyl secretion or antacid, which acts as antacid. Omeprazole is one of the important drugs which contribute for inhibition of proton pump or H+K+ATPase pump. Anyhow, gastrin secretory tumor can indirectly induce peptic ulceration. Next, diagnosis. Epigastric pain, which is observed at the apical surface of the gastric surface, can be diagnosed by different symptoms: pancreatitis, biliary colic acute cholecystitis. Cholecystitis is the obstruction of biliary tract. It is means inflammation. Perforation, acute appendicitis, or malignancy. These are the alarming signs for epigastric pain: chronic GI bleeding, iron deficiency anemia, progressive unintentional weight loss, progressive dysphagia, persistent vomiting, epigastric mass, etc. Dysphagia is one of the important symptoms for gastric problem. Due to continuous destruction of the mucus layer, the person or subject cannot able to take food properly. These are the important signs which indirectly indicate peptic ulceration. The main diagnosis technique for confirmation of peptic ulcer is H. pylori testing. H. pylori is a typical bacteria which is responsible for urea production. It has inert urease activity. C. urea blood testing is one of the important parameters for H. pylori testing. Number two, stool antigen testing. As H. pylori form antigen in our body, through stool, these antigens are released continuously. Serological test. And the most important testing method for confirmation of the location of the disease or this area of peptic ulceration is the endoscopy. Endoscopy is the technique for evaluation and identification of the area of peptic ulceration. A camera attached technique is used directly after insertion of this camera within the GI tract. We can directly observe through computerized method about the ulceration process and confirm the area or the amount of ulceration properly. This is the overall diagrammatic representation of peptic ulceration. After gastric ulceration, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug should be avoided. H. pylori testing is necessary. If it is positive, then endoscopy test is necessary. If after endoscopy, several perforation, if the doctor can confirm, then the several treatment plans will be prescribed. Sometimes peptic ulceration can induce malignancy, which can be crucial for the patient. In case of acute peptic ulceration, 10% mortality or death can be observed. This is the summary of peptic ulceration. A peptic ulcer is a break in superficial epithelial cells penetrating down to the muscularis mucosa of stoma. Duodenal ulceration is more prominent than gastric ulceration. In primary condition, this can be asymptomatic, that means without any symptoms or low symptoms. H. pylori is one of the important factors for formation of peptic ulceration. H. pylori can be diagnosed by C. urea blood testing, stool antigen or serological test, and can be cured or treated with different drugs. Complication of peptic ulceration disease can lead to acute emergency of upper GI bleeding. This is the end of peptic ulceration. In these three videos, I have discussed what is peptic ulceration, risk factors for peptic ulceration, pathogenesis of peptic ulceration, mainly H. pylori infection and Zollinger elision syndrome, diagnosis, next topic, and evaluation or treatment protocol. At the end of this topic, I would like to mention the important question from this area. Number one, write a short note on peptic ulceration. Write a short note on peptic ulceration. Number two, role of H. pylori, information of peptic ulceration. Role of H. pylori, information of peptic ulceration. Number three, diagnosis of peptic ulceration. Diagnosis of peptic ulceration. Number four, signs and symptoms of peptic ulceration. Signs and symptoms of peptic ulceration. This is the end of the topic peptic ulceration. In the next video, I will discuss a new topic for BPA 202 special pathology syllabus. Thank you. Stay safe at home.